bed's very bouncy. Surprise! I am so happy and so relieved because I have checked into my new hotel. Let me show you my new room. So this is the front door, bathroom. It's a lot more modernized and it's just another single king bed, as you can see. And finally, a decent office chair. But let me show you the best part. How beautiful. So I actually looked up what ship that is. And as you can see, it says LHD-5. This is the USS Bataan. It's an amphibious assault ship. And it looks like they're doing some maintenance on it. But man, what a view. Such a breath of fresh air, finally. Also, you know what time it is. Disinfection time. Good morning. It is currently 6:13. Lots of gel. Gonna soft bun it. I have a lot of layers in my hair, so it's not always the easiest. I know this is blonde, I used to have blonde hair, but this is what I use. And we're done. I tend to get a lot of blisters if I wear my boots for a really long time. I don't know if it's just the fit of it or something, but these help protect the heel. A reason why that you may tend to get blisters is because you have space between the shoe and your foot. This is how you put on your boots. But you do want to pull the laces pretty tight. I just kind of tie it to the side and then I stick the laces into the shoe. And you're gonna need these. Just cuffs on like that. And the point of what that bungee is that you tuck pants into them. Just like that. All right, you guys, so I'm about to head out the door and check in to my intermediate duty station. Wish me luck. Hi there. So I just got back not too long ago from my first day of processing. Today was a very long day, as expected. We were given a schedule and I'm surprised that we stuck with the schedule pretty precisely. Today was all about getting the information, getting briefed properly on what to expect for the rest of the week and of course what to expect in the near future for deployments. You know, medical exams, updated immunizations. We also had a JAG officer come in and talk to us about possibly setting up a power of attorney, setting up a will, all these things. So it was a jam-packed day of tons of information. As you know, this is gonna be my first deployment, so all these experiences right now are just completely new for me. You know, this will give you a little bit of insight on, you know, possibly what to expect if you are going this deployment route. Hi, so I just got back from day two of processing, quite early actually. So I was pretty much done by 10:30 this morning. And today purely consisted of medical. We just took care of vaccination requirements. And obviously this is dependent on where you're deploying to. So certain regions do need certain types of vaccines. But other than that, once you were done with medical, you were free to go.
Oh yeah.
So I'm back. Hi, so I'm currently at the car rental center. Just picked up a rental. You know me, just gotta make sure that everything is super clean. So they were nice enough to give me my own rental to take care of the rest of this week, so that should be super convenient.
Oh yeah!
It was snowing a bit, and actually it's snowing a lot now. It's so pretty. I don't know if you can kind of see it in the back window there. Cool. Let's go.
Hi. So, just came back from day 3 and another easy day. So, day 3 consisted of, at least for me, I had to go very early in the morning to dental to get my exam updated. And shout out to Sewell Dental Clinic because they were able to get me also a pro fee, which was nice, and my teeth are all super shiny. That's pretty much it. And then after that, we just did a medical checkout just to make sure that, okay, you got your immunizations, any sort of medications if it pertains to you, and we were all good to go.
That's how I...
A YouTube channel.
Yeah.
Go ahead. I like that.
Hi, good morning. So it is day 5, also the last day of processing today, and I wasn't able to make an update from yesterday because I just forgot, but yesterday was a really quick day as well. It just consisted of going through a gas mask brief. Now this morning, just been running around getting signatures for final checkout, so it hasn't been too bad though, or maybe I'm just getting used to this kind of protocol procedure. So one very crucial thing to consider, regardless if you're in the military or not, is that you should have a power of attorney or will set up. You know, like I don't like to think morbidly or think, you know, unfortunate events would happen, but it is, you know, something that you have to realistically think about. You know, no one ever wants to think about death, especially when you're young. And yes, I am still young. There are JAG officers. These are basically attorneys that work for the Navy. So because you are active duty or the reserves, you have the right to see someone regarding if you needed a trial attorney or setting up a will, power of attorneys, anything that's legal related, or you just need some legal advice, then they are available for you to assist with that. And the great thing is that you don't have to pay anything, and you definitely want to make sure that the people you love are taken care of if something were to happen. So that is my tidbit for today. I will not be making videos of my current state, of course. I'm not going to be making videos on where I'm at. That's just a little heads up. A lot of you guys might be curious on where I'm going, but until I come back and feel comfortable with sharing certain amounts of information, I will decide on when to disclose that. Thank you again for following along my journey. I know it's been kind of chaotic for me, and I'm not trying to stress you guys out by saying, oh my god, it's crazy, like nothing's working out, but sometimes the reality is this is the ins and outs of joining the military in general. That is what you technically sign up for. If they need you and you are chosen, like, that's it, you go. And
you make sure you, you know, complete your duties, complete your mission, and you do a good job, and you come back. And that's pretty much how it is. And I'm getting honestly more and more excited about it, because the people I've talked to this week of processing, some people have flew through it, some people have actually been stationed there before, and it's nice to just get that kind of feedback so that I can form kind of like my baseline opinion on what to expect. But obviously, until I get there and work there, I'm not gonna truly know what it's gonna be like. But that like a little bit of unknown, or a lot bit of unknown, is what's exciting. But I do really enjoy sharing these experiences, because when I was a pre-dental student, or even when I was a dental student, or even when I became a dentist going into the Navy, I just felt like there wasn't a surplus of information out there. It's a lot of hearsay. Either way, I hope that you have thoroughly enjoyed these vlogs, and I really do thank you guys for joining me along this journey and for your support. Please don't be a stranger. If you want to drop a comment or question, I do try to read through them and respond to the best of my ability. I don't know everything, you guys, because the Navy is, it's a big organization, but what I can share is my personal experience for you guys, as well as just things that I have personally gone through, so I know what to expect or how to answer your questions. But sometimes I don't know, but I will try to get you an answer. Again, I hope you guys are staying very happy, especially safe, and of course, as always, stay flossy.